Hi dear subscribers and viewers. So today we're going to be learning how to make this hat. Let me give you a breakdown on what we're going to be learning. We're going to learn how to mold this fascinator and avoid gum stains between the crown and base, how to put the net material on just the crown, how to use the net to form a rose, and generally put everything together. So sit back and let's dive in. So this is the mold we're going to be using, and this is our sinamay. We're going to be using two pieces, and this is the net we're going to be placing on top. So what you do after you have put your stiffener on them, you've placed them in position, you need to get the shape of the mold. Now, to ensure you get the shape of the mold, you would need to take a bias or rope and you put it around the dent. You understand the division between the crown and the base, like I'm doing. So you put on the north, south, east, and west, as I'm doing positions. Then after you do that, you start filling it up. Now, the reason why I use bias or rope, as the case may be, but I'm using bias this time around, is to ensure, in case I don't take out the thumb tags early enough, it doesn't rust my material. I'm sure some of you have noticed when you take out your thumb tags that it's rusted or so, and that's because of the chemical reaction between metal and air. Alright, before we proceed, if you don't know how to mold, if you don't know how I got to this stage, it means you're just joining my channel for the first time. But don't worry, at the end of this video, I would give you the next video to watch, so you know how to cut out your material that you want to use to mold, how to start the mold. You would get to know what to do. So just stick with me here. But if you want to do that, first of all, I would leave the link in the description of this video below. Okay, so you will soon get to know what to do to avoid the accumulation of stiffener at the end, which will now give you some gum stains. I would let you know that very soon. But let's keep going on and seeing how to make this beautiful gold flamboyant fascinator. So after you have done that, you want to lift up the net. If you want the net to cover everywhere, you proceed with the next step. But if you want it just to be on the crown, what you do is you lift up that part and you start cutting it out from where the bias stops. Can you see what I'm doing? So I'm trimming it off at that position. So keep watching and learning. The next process is to turn your mold the other way around, upside down. And you do, what is this process? If you are a subscriber and you've been watching my videos, you already know that it is north, south, east, and west. Why do we do this? We do this to ensure that when we mold, you have smooth edges, as in your fascinator comes out looking smooth everywhere. Now, if you notice, this mold actually is curved. There's a way the base is. So this is what you need to do to ensure that you have the minimum pleats that you can have. In fact, it will be almost smooth all round. So this is what you do. You use your hand and you do that hand motion you saw me doing. And once you, can you see what I'm doing? Then you clip it with your thumbnail. So this is what I'm going to be doing in between all those pins that I have already put. Let's take a slight break for those who are just joining me for the first time in this great channel of mine. You can see that we normally have some progressions. You would have learned some videos from some videos and like that, and it keeps stepping up. So you wanna click that subscribe button right now and press the bell so you get notified immediately I put up any video. Okay, so let's jump back in. So this is the mold after it had stayed like 1 hour. I didn't let it stay for too long, and I started taking off the bias. Now, can you see that there's an accumulation of gum stain? All you need to do is take a foam, dab it with water, and scoop it all out, and it comes out looking wonderful like this. So now I've already attached an elastic band to that place where you just saw. Then you'll be needing your bias and your uhu gum and those pieces. Yes, I forgot to tell you, you don't throw them away. Then this is some trimmings, flower trimmings, and your matching needle and thread, scissors, pegs, favorite pegs that makes our work fast. And hat wire that I have already wrapped with this. If you don't know how to wrap this hat wire, you check the description channel and you'll get to know how to do that. I will give you a link on another video we have made. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is cut out your flower trimmings, because I'm not going to be using all. So what I did was to cut it out straight like that. Can you see? Okay, so I'm going to be cutting it all the way down before I decorate. Then the next thing I did was to cut out the nets. Can you see? I'm going to have like this. I'm going to cut them out in that form, in that shape, like a diamond shape, or would you say a leaf shape? Yeah, like a leaf shape. So this is what I did. After I've cut in leaf shape, to get the other ones, I would just curve them up like so, like I'm doing right now, to get the shapes that I want. So who else has used this net before, and what is it called in your locality? When you want, when you go to the shop to buy this net, what is it called? Do let me know in the comment section below what it's called where you are. So can you see, I'm going to be cutting out 4 pieces of this. That done, the next thing we're going to do is take our hat wire and push it in. If you don't know how to do this also, how to get the size, I would leave a link in the video below of one of the videos we've done already to know how to cut out your hat wire. Now, the reason why we cover the hat wire in this case, you know, in most cases when you see me making the fascinator with mould, with pad rather, I don't cover the hat wire with bias. But in this case, you have to cover it with bias, because cinnamon, I used only 2 layers of cinnamon. Even when I use 3 layers, I still do the same, because cinnamon, you can see through. Do you understand? And you don't want it rusting and being visible, because if it, of course, mixes with air, you know the chemical reaction. So this is how we cover it up, and I'm making use of uhu gum to glue it all the way around. What do you use to cover yours? As we go along, I will tell you the reason what I learned using uhu gum against using candle glue gum. Okay, let's get back to this training. Now, these are the leaves we have cut out. You can see that it's curving, and that is because stiffener has already been applied to it. So I was thinking, after I had already done this, I was like, another option you could also do to make it curve well and stay that way for a longer period of time is to sew hat wire to the edges. Do you understand? To take the shape. After you've done that, you use bias and cover it up. So I'm going to be joining it up like this with needle and thread to form that lovely rose that is not complete. Seems like it has one petal missing. So keep watching and learning. okay, and the next thing I did was cut out another piece and I placed it in the middle of the sewing that I did to join this our rows to the heart. So can you see, just like that. Okay, the next thing is to take your trimmings and design it the way I did. You might want to design yours differently, that's okay. All right, and I'm going to be making use of uhu gum to glue them into position. So while you're watching how I do that, now let me tell you what I discovered in using uhu gum against candle glue gum when gluing the trimmings of this gold flamboyant fascinator. What I did, what I noticed was that, you know, when you're using candle glue gum, you really have to take care. This has to dry. There's a technique to it. It has to dry a bit before you fold it. If not, it gets stained. You see the stain on the other side, but uhu was quite easier. The only thing about uhu is that you have to ensure that when you put your pegs, you leave them for long. And that forms this great gold flamboyant fascinator. So as usual, I'll be putting the Amazon links below in the description of this channel for all that I made use of in this tutorial on how to make this gold flamboyant fascinator. That's the ones that I can find on Amazon will be there. But if you can't find that, you can contact me in the DIY kit link below. You can check this next video on how to make this silver fascinator. It also shows you how to cut out your pieces, how to mold it fully, and much more. So till my next video is goodbye and God bless.